almost all of those singers in this are untrained. And these are student performers in the orchestra.
It has been an absolute privilege to sing this piece. It is one of the most beautiful choir pieces I've ever sung. You could see the passion in his eyes when he watches us sing it. I'm really, really pleased to be able to perform it for him.
Particularly I enjoy the lux aeterna, the ebb and flow that comes from the music and the feeling of something new based on something so old with the old plain song coming through in the melodies.
It's really almost a divine is really the word for it, yet so simple, sort of built on a couple of harmonic and melodic gestures which Lauridsen manages to take to the height of greatness. So it's just a really special piece to sing. Why choral music is so satisfying is to be so transported with other people into something that's very outside of yourself and bigger than yourself. And Lauridsen unlocks that, I think, in a very deep way, especially for choral singers. He's a choral singer's composer.
This is maybe the third or fourth time I've sung it, and I feel like I'm learning more with it every time. I'm feeling more, maybe, of what he was intending us to feel, and I really feel like it's an amazing piece for the way we sing with Bob, the cohesive nature. And he had us right with him, and it felt beautiful. And like the accomplishment of singing Onata Lux the way, maybe, the way Lauridsen wanted us to, and singing in tune, it feels different. It feels different in your body. The only composer I've ever sung where the breathing together is a part of the music in such an incredible way.
When I first started writing choral music, one of my inspirations was actually listening to pieces by Morten Lauridsen. And I didn't know who he was, and I was naive. I hadn't listened to much choral music in my life, mostly orchestra and chamber music. And all of a sudden, it became like an addiction. I have to say this because, and I listened to the Chamber Choir of Europe's recording of it and many others. And it almost became like a drug. I put his music on during the day if I wanted to calm myself down, if I wanted to be in a good mood. And it really actually inspired some of my first choral pieces, and is still really important to me.
Choruses are great about commissioning new work. They have a big appetite for learning new music and for championing new composers, which is fantastic. But a favorite, of course, is Morten Lauridsen. His music is so accessible, so beautiful, and something that choirs of all kinds can work on and achieve, something more beautiful than any individual could do on their own. Morten's music really connects, and I think that's what makes it so popular for the choruses and their audiences alike. One of the benefits of my job is I get to hear a lot of choral music concerts, and recently I found myself at two. The first concert was an all Mozart concert, and it was fantastic. The second was the music of Morten Lauridsen. And again, the audience was full and they were delighted at the end of the performance. The difference was Morten was at his concert. And how thrilling is that to have a composer who's so popular writing about situations of the day in music that is so universal and have him among us? That's cool.
Morten Lauridsen as a composer is aiming at the highest goal of art, which is to make the transcendent perceptible. That is what is communicated so movingly in his music. And one immediately senses a stillness in the man. One already knows the stillness from his music, and in Michael Stillwater's extraordinary film, that stillness is beautifully captured in the beauty of his surroundings, of his music, and in the man himself. His music is worthy of the preceding silence because it knows that this silence is not a form of emptiness, but it's gestational, it's full. And when one is immersed in it, you create basically the sound of that silence.
Thank you.
That's when music is at its most beautiful. And when it touches upon the permanent things, when it touches upon eternity, and that is what he has achieved in his remarkable music.
Manu Mysterium, a wonderful sacred text, which has been set by many, many, many composers through the ages as one of the texts that people set going way back to the medieval times. And Morten Lauridsen's setting was so incredibly beautiful. I remember wondering whether my choir soundings could actually do it and do it justice. And I finally decided it wasn't a question of whether we could do it. The bigger question in my mind was, how could we not do it?
I'm so grateful to this man, Morten Lauridsen, for having the courage to write from his own pain, his own suffering, and to go to the great, timeless wisdom of his text and make it accessible, make this music accessible to everyone.
There's another feature about his music. It deals with profound loss. And we know from what he himself has said that Lux Aeterna was written as his mother was dying. Now, what Morten has been able to do is not simply experience loss as a terrible, terrible emptiness. He puts it in the context of the meaning of the loss. That life, though it passes, is redeemable. That in fact it finally isn't a loss. And that is why there is a trail in his music, both in the forms and the languages he employs, going back to Renaissance and medieval music that is traditional, but also with some modern harmonies. So nothing is lost in his music itself, which is about the recovery from loss and what the true meaning of the loss is in that context of redemption. So this also is music expressive of a very profound and deep faith. I don't think he could touch upon eternity in the way he does. I don't think he could make the transcendent perceptible in the way he does without that ground of faith in him. And it speaks to people not in any sectarian way, though he's using some Latin texts. It just goes right to the soul.